Welcome back to my channel. Today is day 8 of 30 Days of Sketches with Christy's Beautiful Life. And today we are working on a 2-page sketch by Deb Tallbrod. And I am using some pictures we had taken while we were at Disney in January and February. And these were taken by the Toy Story Land sign. And so these were memory maker photos, and so I wanted to showcase them. I always have kind of an issue with some of the professional ones that they take for you at the park because it's sort of us just sort of posing, but I really like this. And I am using some background paper. This is a digital paper that I printed out from the Dining with Toys collection from Kelly Bell Designs. This is a digital, I printed it on a wide format printer. That's not necessarily something that you have to do when you're working with digital paper. As I've said in previous videos, you can certainly print them in whatever size you would like. I just decided to make that my entire background. And I have these cute little cut files from Cricut Design Space that I'm working on, some blocks and some Tinker Toys. Now, the Toy Story Land title came from a swap that I had participated in. And I also have the cut file. And so I used some of the Tinker Toys here. And I'm going to go ahead and add those to my design as well. And so I'm just sort of laying it out to decide how I would like to do it. And I have to tell you, when it came to this, I had sort of a plan. Obviously, I had the sketch in mind, and I had sort of a plan of what I wanted to do with the cut files, but I sort of rode the struggle bus on this one, guys. And I'm still not like 100% sure I like the way it turned out, but you know what? It's another page in the books, and so I'm okay with that, and I'm not looking back. So I have them all kind of laid out here, and then I'm going to just glue those down once I kind of figure out what I want to do. So now I have them glued down, and I decided I wanted to put some green army men on there. And in one of the photos, we're pointing to some green army men who are parachuting down. And so I have this wonderful set of die cuts from Scraps and Ink Craft on Etsy. And I'm just going to run those through my Sizzix. And then they are pretty much done. I'm just going to leave them as is. You could certainly add things to them. I think it would be great to add some dimensional adhesive so that they sort of look like the shiny army men. But since everything else was sort of flat, I'm just going to leave it as is. But there's a lot of things that you can do with these. So, and this does make it really easy to do. And so once I'm done with that, then I'm just going to kind of arrange things. So I have my block tower there, which is sort of mimicking what's there in the picture. And then I decided that the fencing is sort of Tinker Toy-ish. I think it's actually Kinects, if I was being entirely correct with it. But I'm going to go ahead and make some Tinker Toy sort of gates there and connect them, and then pretty much the layout comes together pretty well. But as far as the embellishments, I wasn't really 100% sure how I wanted it to go, but I think it worked out okay. So as I'm working on this, and this is one of the reasons that I love Toy Story Land so much, is because it's very nostalgic. It's sort of, some of the classic toys really do bring me back to my childhood. And especially the Tinker Toys. I have some very, very special memories with playing with Tinker Toys. When I was younger, we used to go over to my neighbor's house, and she would always get the Tinker Toys out for me. And so I have a special place in my heart for all things Tinker Toys. So there is my question of the day. Do you have a special childhood toy that you really enjoy? Do you still have it? Give me a look into your childhood and let me know what kind of toys were really special for you and what kind of memories do they evoke? Because this obviously, anytime I look at Tinker Toys, I absolutely think about hanging out over there and just playing with those while my neighbor and my grandmother used to hang out together. So it was really special to me. And I'm very glad going to Toy Story Land is just such a fun part of Hollywood Studios. If you've never been, I think it's definitely a place to go. I love the rides and all of that, but having everything being so exaggerated in size and really feeling like a toy is such a remarkable thing that Disney does. The Imagineers just are fantastic and have just an incredible creativity about them, and I love it every time I go. And so here's where I'm kind of riding the struggle bus again. I wasn't 100% sure how I wanted to put the rest of these blocks and Tinker Toys together, so I'm gonna move them around a little bit, and then they're finally gonna find their final destination in their home. I'm still not 100% sure that I am happy with it, but I'm going to say that it is done and it's going in my books. And sometimes you have pages that you like, and sometimes you have pages that are like, eh, it's okay. And that's kind of where I'm at with this one. But it's okay because I've documented the memory, and anytime I look back at it, hopefully I will be able to look back and think about the times that we've spent in Toy Story Land and Hollywood Studios and just kind of enjoy it. So there you go, guys. This is my final layout. If you like the video, make sure you hit that thumbs up. And if you're not yet a subscriber, I would love it if you would hit that subscribe button. It really does help my channel out a lot, and it makes me happy, and I appreciate it very, very much. So I hope you all have a magical day, and I will see you next time. Bye, everyone.